Ah, oh, my precious. Ah, oh, my precious. G'day and welcome to Black Opal Direct. My name's Justin. Well, today I have an obby here that could be a risk. It could cut, but I'm seeing hints of blue, bright blue color coming out of it. So we could get ourselves a really nice stone out of this one. But it's really hard to tell how much color bar there is inside it and whether there's sand spots. Now I've run the flashlight through it, the gem torch, and it is showing up like there's light going through it, but that doesn't mean always that there's no sand inside. So we're gonna have to have a crack on the wheel and see if this guy cleans up. So I'll take you through step by step. Come on, let's do it now. So I'm trialing out a new gem flashlight as well. This one has an adjustable light, so it can get very, very powerful or very dim, which is quite good. So I want to find out whether that color bar is clean. So I'm going to turn, whoops, wrong way, that light. Oh, look at that. It looks like it may be clear in there. I'm going to shine the light. Seems to have light traveling right through. So that's a bonus. We are winning. We're ahead on the opal risk assessment. So let's get rid of that. And we could be ready to go on the wheel, I think, and just clean up those edges. So let me turn the machine on. Little bit of water, please. There it is. Okay, so I'm going to just take it on the wheel a little bit. You can see I just took that on that wheel, just cleaned up the skin. So the whole piece has pretty much got skin all over it, and the skin is rough, so it's very hard to tell what's going on inside. So I'm just going to go around it a little bit and see how much of that skin cleans up. So that's giving us a pretty good idea about this piece and how it's going to look once it's cut. Now, there is an issue with this potch here. This is very healthy potch, and this is unhealthy potch. And this is what we call in Lightning Ridge, we call matrix. And that matrix can be very unhealthy for the opal. Now you can tell by when you grind it, you can see it looks like cancer. The potch is not clean. It's not a nice potch. It's a very unclean potch. And let me show you a closer up shot in the light box. So with this type of potch here, if you leave that on the opal, sometimes the pressure of this type of potch sitting on that type of color can make the stone crack. And in order to avoid that, you have to take that off. And it's pretty sad that you do, but we're going to have to use that black side as the back. And we're going to have to grind that away because that is unhealthy potch. I'll show you a little bit further down once I've ground it further. So you can really see that there's all these lines through it. It's a very, very unhealthy potch that actually dries out or soaks in water a little bit easier than normal, and it can put pressure on the good colour. So we have to say goodbye. So let's grind a little bit of that away. Go back out to one, here we go. Alright, so now we've hit the colour. So you can see the colour is just starting to come through. And we're going to try and take all of that off to get a stone underneath. So we've still got plenty of colour bar all the way down to there to get that out. So we can still work on it more to get it to a nice clean stone. That window there, that can come off because there's sand and it's lighter than the rest of the stone. So I can just take that off that corner, like so. We can pretty much give it the shape it's needed already, because we know now, we know that that color bar is clean, and all of that stuff on the top, when I start rounding the edge like this, it should all just start to come out. You can see it's starting to come out. So as I said before, this piece has naturally dark colour, so this colour bar is naturally dark. So if I was to hold it up to the light now, you will see a little bit of colour, or you see some light coming through the piece, as you can see. So it's becoming more of a black crystal than a black opal. Rightio, there we go, we've got a nice blue black opal. One small inclusion sitting there that will come out on the dot stick. So we've rubbed it out. Beautiful little blue black opal, black crystal opal now, and we're ready to put it on the dot stick. Let's get that flame going. Do the usual dopping without burning my fingers on the wax. Nice and even. Now we're ready to stick that on the wheel. Thank you. So this opal is a nice little black crystal opal. It's very dark. It sits in the black opal category on the body tone scale, but it has a brightness of about 1.5 to 2. And that makes it quite subdued in color. And some people like that. Some people like opals that aren't too bright, but it's not for everyone. And because of the subtleness of the color and brightness, it's a bluey purple. It's worth around about the $400. So it's not a really expensive gem, but it's still a nice gem. And it's a good size with a cabochon for a ring. So what am I gonna do with this stone?
Honey, would you like some lunch?
That'd be lovely, darling.
All right, I'll go make you some.
Don't worry, you're my first love.